look at is work experience. I am looking at, have you worked in a hospital? I'm going to weight that higher than if you've worked in retail. But we do also like that if you worked in retail. I'm also looking to see if you worked during school. Was it just during the summer? How long have you worked there? Have you had a job for 3 months, or have you kind of held that job for more than a year? So that's the first thing that we look at. The next thing that I look at is, like I mentioned before, the type of API experiences. I'm counting the number of clinical experiences that you have, that you've done. And so I'd like to see a description of what you did on your rotation so that I can understand what type of rotation that it was. And then the last one's kind of a tie. I was having a hard time to decide between leadership and research experience. So I'd say those tie for third.
Much sums it up. Work experience is a big deal to me, just because I feel like if you have like any type of work experience, you're going to know what it's like to operate in a work environment in the real world. So work experience is probably one of the higher things on my list. Then extracurriculars and leadership activities. You know, have you held office and like needed to manage time commitments and workload between school and extracurriculars? And then professional presence too, like you've already done like a poster presentation, had some research experience. Those are probably like the top three things.
I mean, I would say that's difficult because there's certain things you just expect to be there. So obviously you're looking there first. Probably if you were looking specifically for items that would set applicants apart from one another, is really looking for, have they been involved with a research project? Because that's above and beyond most people's curriculum. So those are likely experiences they had to seek out. And then obviously publications would not be something I would expect, but if I saw it, it would definitely be something that I would note, especially on our scoring rubric. Again, those are probably things that are above and beyond. One area that I expect to see there, but sometimes people accidentally leave off, is presentations. They just assume, well, I gave these presentations on rotation. And yes, presentations on rotations are expected, but you still do need a list, especially those higher stake ones, especially if you gave an in-service to your medical team. So yeah, it's a short presentation, but you had to take information and put it together for your team, and you're giving it to an interprofessional audience. So, you know, I'm looking for those. I'm looking for even, you know, short presentations that you gave above and beyond kind of just to like other pharmacy students and your preceptor, but did you really give, you know, to people outside of pharmacy? So I would say those are probably areas I'm looking for. Some I expect to be something there. Some I'm just pleasantly surprised if I see something.
Yes. So one of the top three items that we're searching for is work experience. It's really important that our candidates have actually spent time outside of their IPPs and APPs in a job, ideally in a pharmacy, though just working to demonstrate that they have the ability to manage the different priorities that happen when working and doing schooling is really important. We also look for community service. This is an area though where candidates tend to maybe overinflate a bit, so we want it to be realistic. We don't need every time that a candidate does an activity, if it's repeating, just reflecting that they've been involved in that. And then the degree to which they've been involved is really helpful. I think what's more confusing is when candidates take time to make their CV look really, really good, but then don't take the time in their forecast application to make sure that that information is entered in those fields as well, because then we have a hard time understanding what truly is community service or recognitions or work experience, because sometimes it's hard to tell, but when they entered in forecast as well, it kind of confirms and helps us to better understand how things line up.